Amitabh, how much credit will you give the Congress? Because yes, it's a huge feat. If you just look at the vote share of the Congress, 2019 it was 6.36, if I'm not wrong. It stands at close to 10%, maybe 9.46% in this election, which is higher than Mayawati, marginally so, where the BSP is concerned. Together, the SP and the Congress, the India Alliance, overshoots the BJP vote share for at least 4%. But this 9.46%, which has translated into 6 seats for the Congress, will you give the credit entirely to the Congress, or a lot of it has to do with the vote transfer from the Samajwadi Party, the cadre of the Samajwadi Party on ground?
See, of course, the Samajwadi Party was the bigger brother of the alliance. So the vote transfer from Samajwadi Party has helped Congress Party win these 6 seats. However, there is one important thing which we need to understand is that how has Samajwadi Party or Congress Alliance been able to win more than the BJP or the NDA bloc? They have got the non-Yadav OBC vote from the BJP, a section of it. The non-Jata vote from the BJP, a section of it. And Jata and Muslim votes from the BSP. So they have damaged both the alliances by 10% vote share each, roughly. Dalit voters, the switch of Dalit voters to the SP Congress Alliance has largely happened, I would say, because Congress was part of that alliance. Because this Dalit Muslim Yadav vote block is not a very cordial sort of a vote block that it would transfer.
The PDA,
so that
is what
I would give credit to Congress.
Pichda Dalit Alpsankhyak.
Yeah. And the second is that even the consolidation of the Muslims, which has happened to the extent of 92%, would not have happened if Congress was not part of the alliance, because Congress is the party which can defeat the BJP at the national level. Of course, it was the junior partner in UP. Mm-hmm. Congress did provide the heft to this alliance to that extent.
But Amitabh Tiwari, there's so much which has been, and I want to get just for a brief while get into this, just humor me. So much been said about the Muslim vote going with the Congress en masse, consolidating 92%. Most of us who were on ground actually thought that the Muslim vote was a negative vote this time, because the Muslim vote went with the political party who they thought could defeat the Bharatiya Janata Party. It wasn't possibly just the vote of the Congress. It happened in so many seats. You're talking about Uttar Pradesh. Take the example of Nagina, where the Muslims voted till about 3 p.m. They saw the Dalits move towards Chandrasekhar Azad and then decided to en masse vote Chandrasekhar Azad.
Yeah, but that's largely one seat, Preeti. But in all other seats, they have consolidated in favor of the Samajwadi Congress Party alliance. Of course, Samajwadi Party itself had some 78 or 80% vote share of the Muslims, even in the 2022 Vidhan Sabha election. But what I'm saying is that it just, Congress added on top of this vote block which Samajwadi Party had, and that perhaps made all the difference, because both the alliances have a vote share of 44%. In that case, it is a nightmare for the pollsters, because there is no difference in vote share when you are extrapolating seats on the basis of vote share.
Well, the CSDS survey actually shows the alliance about 3% more than the BJP, the post-poll survey, at least with what the numbers that we have right now. I'll go back.
The actual number is 44 each.
All right, I've got to go back to the Congress spokesperson. And, ma'am, the question that I'll ask you is, there can be a lot of bravado, there can be a lot of bluster, but what does it rest on? Ultimately, where Uttar Pradesh is concerned, it rests on the laurels of your ally, who was the Samajwadi Party.
Preeti, I want to, just now my BJP panelist was quoting a muhavra. I want to quote a muhavra. Duvidha mein dono gaye, maya mili na ram. The way they have lost Faizabad, the way they have lost the 9 out of 12 constituencies surrounding Varanasi, speaks volume. It's just that Muslims have consolidated and given them vote. Rural distress was a big thing. And when you talk about, we were fighting as an India alliance, we were fighting as a combined bloc. And definitely the major part of the credit goes to the relentless campaigning of Akhilesh Yadav and his insistence on PDA votes. But what we are talking here, what we are debating here is how Ms. Vadra, how is Gandhi Vadra had, steered the campaign in Amethi and Raebareli. I was in Amethi and she brought a woman, she got a woman on stage and she told the public that this woman has fought against the whole of her family to educate her girl child, and she drives inspiration from her. And at that moment, I saw every woman in that public meeting felt belonging or felt a connection that, I'm heard and I matter. And that's how, her emotional cord, her if she took every jibe and every toheen and every tonge of Prime Minister Modi and threw it out of the park, beat Mangal Sutra, beat inheritance tax, and that's how Ms. Priyanka Gandhi Vadra holds a special mention
Okay.
for credit to Akhilesh Yadav's and SP's relentless campaigning too. I think she steered the campaign on her shoulders and she steered it
All
beautifully.
right, okay, for the Congress she might have steered the the campaign, but what does it tantamount to? Sanju Varma, to bring you in, one thing, Sanju Varma, you have to admit, in Uttar Pradesh at least, it's also been an ideological defeat. Why do people talk about so much of Faizabad, on which comes Ayodhya, for the sheer fact that even in Faizabad, what was the slogan? Somewhere down the line, it was the India Alliance whose narrative succeeded. I was there. The slogan Sanju Varma was, Na Mathura na Kashi, is bar Ayodhya mein Pasi.
Preeti, you're a very opinionated woman, and so am I. So when you say Sanju Varma, you have to admit this. I will
okay,
say
don't
this
admit
very
it. Humor me. Don't admit it. Humor me. Okay.
Okay. No. You know that, I've had some extremely feisty but very educative debates with you. But I just want to say a couple of things, because I think your audience is one of the biggest stakeholders in debates like these. I'm willing to say that, yes, BJP's performance in Uttar Pradesh left a lot to be desired. I'm not going to beat around the bush. I'm not going to shove things under the carpet. Because jo sachai hai, wo saamne dikh rahi hai sabko. But what I'm not willing to admit, what I'm not willing to give credit to the Congress for is saying ki are Rahul Gandhi ne dekha kya kamal kar diya, Priyanka Vadra ne kya kamal kar diya. यदि उत्तर प्रदेश में 6 सीटें लाके आप राहुल गांधी की पीठ थपथपाना चाहते हो, यदि उत्तर प्रदेश में मात्र 6 सीटें लाने के बाद प्रियंका वड्रा थिंक्स दैट शी कैन बी द चैलेंजर टू नरेंद्र मोदी, देन आई वुड लाइक टू टेल पीपल देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड ट्रैक रिकॉर्ड इन पॉलिटिक्स. वन स्वॉलो डज नॉट मेक इट अ समर. एंड लुक एट नरेंद्र मोदी ट्रैक रिकॉर्ड, 13 years एज चीफ मिनिस्टर, टू टर्म्स एज प्राइम मिनिस्टर, नाउ इन टू हिज थर्ड टर्म. And Priyanka Vadra is not even sure whether she wants to dirty her feet on the shop floor. As they say in corporate lingo, you can never be a good CEO if you're not willing to dirty your hands on the shop floor. And I think the fact that Priyanka Vadra is reluctant, is hesitant, that shows that she does not have the stomach for a fight. और यदि आप नरेंद्र मोदी को बार बार कहते हो अरे मटन मछली मंगलसूत्र मुजरा इसके कारण बीजेपी वॉज रिड्यूस टू 240, गिव नरेंद्र मोदी क्रेडिट फॉर द फैक्ट दैट वी गॉट मोर देन 80 सीट्स इन ओडिशा फॉर्मिंग अ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ आर ओन एंड डिसलॉजिंग नवीन पटनायक, अ मैन हु रेन्ड एज चीफ मिनिस्टर फॉर 25 लॉन्ग ईयर्स. गिव नरेंद्र मोदी क्रेडिट फॉर द फैक्ट दैट वी गॉट अ
क्रेडिट
मेजोरिटी इन अरुणाचल प्रदेश.
नो, आई वांट टू आस्क यू अ रिबटल. क्रेडिट गिवन वेयर इट्स ड्यू, 100%. What went down in Odisha is historic and credit needs to be given to the Prime Minister. But then, with credit, one also needs to accept some brickbats. Now, do you also admit then, don't admit, but humor me on this, Sanju Varma, where the winning margin of the Prime Minister in Varanasi is concerned? A winning margin of 1,52,000 votes in Varanasi, Sanju Varma, when you won from 4,80,000 votes the last time around in 2019, if the Prime Minister was popular in UP, I'm talking about UP, that winning margin should have doubled from 4 lakh. It's come down to 1,50,000. The Congress is saying this is a moral defeat.
Preeti, let's be very clear. And now again with no offence to you, jo dikhta hai, wahi natija hai. Natija ye hai, Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi defeated his closest contender, Ajay Rai. And for Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Vadra to sit and now hallucinate, yadi Priyanka Vadra ladti, I can say, I can do a better job than Preeti Chaudhary at 9 p.m. It does not work. She has the experience, she has the credibility, she has the momentum going for her. I can say, yadi Rahul Gandhi Amit Shah ke khilaaf ladte, Gandhi Nagar se, Amit Shah won by a margin of more than 7.4 lakh votes, Rahul Gandhi ki dhajjiya ud jati. I can say, yadi Rahul Gandhi Shivraj Chauhan ke saath ladte, तो शिवराज चौहान हैज वन बाय मार्जिन ऑफ 8.42 लाख वोट्स. प्रियंका वड्रा और राहुल गांधी मिलकर भी लड़ते तो उनकी धज्जिया उड़ जाती. मैं ये भी कह सकती हूँ यदि प्रियंका वड्रा सीआर पाटिल के खिलाफ लड़ती नवसारी से, सीआर पाटिल वन बाय मार्जिन ऑफ 7.8 लाख वोट्स, प्रियंका वड्रा की धज्जिया उड़ जाती. क्या हो सकता था? दैट इज नॉट रेलिवेंट. आज का सत्य ये है, डिस्पाइट राहुल गांधी रनिंग अ प्रोपेगेंडा बेस्ड कैंपेन बेस्ड ऑन फॉल्सहुड्स एंड फॉल्स नैरेटिव्स, नरेंद्र मोदी इज प्राइम मिनिस्टर फॉर द थर्ड टाइम रनिंग, इस बात को झुठलाया नहीं जा सकता.